Hi friends, myself I am S.Syed Abdul Haq, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering in S.Syed Institute of Technology, Karyapatti. Now I am going to present the basic concept of smart grid. It is work a vital role in all the power consumption as well as power energy system areas. Smart grid. It is complete the work in a very effective as well as quickly manner. So only it is called smart. Here the power will be generated by the means of nuclear power plant, thermal power plant, wind power plant, solar power plant and hydro power plant. These are all the resources of power generations in smart grid. First of all, we have to know what is the meaning for smart grid. The smart grid is nothing but it is collecting or gathering the data, act on information about the behavior of suppliers and consumers in an automated fashion. The main application of the smart grid is computer intelligence and networking ability to the existing dump electricity distribution systems. The expansion of smart. The S denoted as specific, M denoted as measurable, A denoted as achievable, R denoted as realistic, and T stands for time. What is the main comparison between previous grid as well as smart grid means? The smart grid, it is a digital one. The previous grid is working as an electromechanical manner. The digital mean we can easily get the output very accurately as well as very effectively. And then it is a two-way communication system. That means the data or information will be transferred from supplier to consumer as well as customer to suppliers. So it is a closed loop system. We can easily find out the fault as well as communication error easily compared to previous grid system. And then the more number of sensors used in smart grid compared to the previous grid system. The main differentiations are the smart grid consists of many customer choices. So it is give the importance to the customers and get the feedback from the customers. The smart grid is based on demand follows supply. But the previous grid, it is the supply follow to the demand. This is done by the integrating communication technology to the power grid and inform the consumer about real-time electricity prices through their smart meters, which would be called smart meters. And then it is a conventional power grid and complete the work in a new smart look fashions. So only it is called as a smart grid. The smart grid control and information system consists of three types of layers. The power is mainly product as well as controlling. It is very essential part in a smart grid. It is consists of three types of layer. The first one is master station system layer. Second one is remote communication network layer. Third one is field network layer. And final, the base layer is terminal layer. The each layers are connected through the bus bar. It is each layer consists of two types of communication systems. One is wireless communication, second one is wired communication. In wireless communication network, we are using 2G, 3G, LTE technologies. But in wired communication, most of the probably we are using optical fiber communication only. In terminal layers, we are used the four types of devices. The first one is remote terminal device. Second one is information collection device. Third one is smart meters and smart device. Fourth one is intelligent electronic devices. And then in our nation, how the Indian smart grid journey started means it is consist of two major parts. One is the mission as well as vision. The vision means it is a long time goal of our Indian nation smart grid journey. The first one is to transform the Indian power sector into a secure, adaptive, sustainable, and digitally enabled ecosystem that provides reliable and quality energy for all with active participation of stakeholders. Because in smart grid, we are mainly depending on customers' choices. And then the mission, it is a short-term goal. It is establishment of National Smart Grid Missions in power sector on March 27, 2015. It is mainly used for monitor and implementation of the policies. The activities budgets are 338 crores. The smart substation. The substation mainly used for transfer one set of powers into one stations to another stations. The smart substation consists of three levels. The first level is station level, second one is bay level, third one is process level. The station level is the first layer, first level of the substations. It is mainly used for the recording as well as production purpose. And then time synchronization gateway for remote communications. The bay level, it is connected between the station level as well as process level. The bay level mainly used for recording the disturbance and issuing for commands related to on the generating disturbance. The process level, it is the base level of this smart substation. It is mainly used for controlling as well as production line productions. So it is called some data acquisition methods. The smart substation. The smart substation mainly used for improving power quality, reliability and load profile. We are find out the disturbance as well as communication error means that time only we can achieve the or improving the power quality levels. The number of distributed energy resource and new appliance with power electronics in the distribution grid rapidly grows. This leads to power quality problem as well as power flow fluctuations. It is mainly maintain the power quality and reliability in economic way. The change in electricity demand and supply. It is consists of three essential points. First one is higher simultaneous peak demand, more power electronics equipment, more renewable energy and distributed generators. The technological advance in substation production and controls. It is consists of five major technology to improve the smart meters. The first one is evaluation of production and controls. Second one is phasor measurement unit. Third one is battery monitoring. Fourth one is power circuit breakers monitoring. Fifth one is power transformer monitoring. The substation automation. The substation automation refers to using data from intelligent electronic device, IED, control and automation capabilities within the substations and control commands from remote users to control power system devices. The substation automation mainly consists of two units. First one is remote terminal unit. Second one is standard protocols. The remote terminal units consist of serial bus bars, bus communication. It is consist of RS-232, RS-485, RS-422. The standard protocols. The protocol is nothing but it is a group or set of data which is fetched in a devices. It is consists of Modbus, IEC, DNP3, ICCP. It is mainly used in wide area telemetry as well as program logic control units. These are all the overall structures of basic concepts of smart grid as well as the smart grid journey in our India nation. Thank you.